Hello everyone. In today's video, I'm going to tell you Python pandas. Okay? Now, before studying pandas, I'd like to tell you that few things from the syllabus is removed and few new things have been added. Okay? So among those, panda is there. Now, how this panda will be used in this programming? Okay? Why you will learn pandas? Right? What is the importance of learning this pandas, right? So let us see that how we will think that we should learn pandas, we should use pandas, okay? So now, before telling you anything about the pandas, let's start the word, the key point, the base, and that is everything for this world and this programming language too, right? And for this technology also, that is the data. Now, when you have started programming, that time it is taught to you that the programs are written to manipulate this data, right? For manipulation of this, manipulation of data. Right? Programs are written and this generates information. Right, everyone? And one more fact I have mentioned you about this information is that information may again become data for another information. And this manipulation is called process. Very well clear to you that what the process is, what the data is, what the information is, and that information is again used for the further processing, right? That information may become data for another information, right? These words are data and information is interchangeable word, and I have told you the fact about the data also and information also, that there is having three facts about the data and information, that when the right data is given to the right person, right data, right person on right time. These three points are very important for the information. Lack of any one of three, this information will be completely useless. So to make the information useful, these three things are very important. To the right person, information should be conveyed to the right person. Information should be conveyed on right time, and correct information should be conveyed, right? Now, so now let us see that this information, sometimes we are also calling it as a data, right? So what is the importance of this data? If you will start observing, then you will find out that without data nothing is there, okay? And each and every second we are gathering data, we are creating data, and data is being generated, okay? Every second, what the time is going now, so we are, the time leaves the collection of data, right? Time leaves the collection of data, time gives the collection of data, right? So now let us see that how this data is surrounding to this world, okay? And how that world is surrounded by this data, okay? How this world is surrounded by the data. So let us see some of the bodies of this world, okay? Bodies, some organizations of this world, right? Now, so let us see first, the very important one is the hospital. Okay? Why this body is there? Without this body, it is very difficult to lead our life, okay? So this hospital is there to treat the patients. Okay, and they keeps the records of medical records of the patients. They keeps the medical records of the patients. Patients, right? They keeps the prescriptions of the patient. Right, in the form of data and many more data is stored by the hospital. Right? Now, come to the another organization, another body which is very important, that is bank. What this bank does? This bank is there for dealing with the customers. And what kind of deal they have? They are managing the transaction. Transactions of their customers. Okay? They are containing the data, they are maintaining the data regarding the customers' transactions. Okay? Now, another important body is what? There is having any, some of the, you can also take the example of share market. You can take the example of share market. How the data is collected by the share market? You can say that share market, it contains a minute to minute change in the value. It contains the minute to minute change in the value. So now you can think that how huge amount of data will be maintained by the share markets. You can take the example of another that is very broad range have, that is a business. Business, okay? Organization. Business organizations does what? They maintain the records of their sales. They maintain the records of their purchasing. They maintain the records of production. Right? So like that we can take any body which is running in our, in this world. Any example we can take, you can also take the example of your school, right? So you will find out that organizations are, data is generated in every minute, every second, right? And the respective, the related data, the required data by the organization is maintained by the particular organizations, okay? So you will find out that we are roaming around the data. Or you can say this world is roaming around this data, right? So you can think that how huge data we have, how huge number of data any organization have. But what happens to this huge amount of the data? What happens to the, when the data becomes older? No. One thing I told you, that information never lost, right? You cannot say that any information is meaningless or it can be lost, and you will not need any information. So what happened to those data? Data cannot be destroyed. So what happened? All those data are, when it becomes older, so they are sent to one use repository system. They are sent to one use repository system, that is the data warehouse. Right? So this data, huge amount of data is sent to the repository system. A huge amount of data is stored by the data warehouse, right? So when it contains the data, when it goes to the data warehouse, so what is the use of this data in the data warehouse, right? So one very important thing, that any organization looks for their growth. Any organization looks for their growth, and for that they are making some strategies, right? They are making some plans, okay? So when they are making some strategies or the plans, so they are always looking to their previous data. They are always looking to their previous status, right? Now, so from where they will get those data? So the organizations will get the data from this warehouse. Okay, the organizations will get the data from this data warehouse, right? So what? Data warehouse is containing huge amount of data, right? So what data the organization will get? one thing is very well clear to you. When you have worked with the database MySQL, there you have seen that from the table we are not always using, or we don't require all the data from the table always, right? We are extracting the selected data from the table and we are displaying in the form, particular format, right? Now, so similarly here also, any company don't require their all data. They require their summarized data. They require the data based on their requirement. They require the data on which they can take the decisions, right? Now, so that data cannot directly send to the organizations. Those data is summarized, those data is processed first, and then it is given to the company. So who is doing that work, right? Now, so now let us see that what the picture is being drawn when the data goes to the data warehouse, and after that organizations requires analysis on their old data, right? So just let us see. You have a huge data repository system, that is data warehouse. Okay, here is the business organizations or companies. Right? Now, after that, when the business organizations looks for the their growth, right? So they are making their strategies, right? Now, so what happened there? To for that purpose, they are going with the contact with the data science. For that, there the data science is existing. Clear? For that, data science is existing because business organizations want only those data which is required for them to plan for their further growth, right? To do some analysis. Okay, so they contact to the data science, and data science dig out the data from the data warehouse for the business organizations, right? For that sake, they are have this data science is having various strategies, and this data science, when extracts or dig out the data from the data warehouse, it represents, it gives the information, it gives to the organization or any business organization in the very efficient and effective form, right? And that is done by this data science, and that for that they have introduced pandas. For that, here pandas is introduced. So now panda is having the role here for the data science. Okay, now whenever any requirement is asked by the organization from the data science, clear? From the data science. So what this data science does, this data science goes to the warehouse and it extracts the data. Right? And what kind of data it extracts? It extracts the data on which the business organization can plan, right? So what the data is extracted and just presented to the business organizations? No, they are not presented in that manner. They are made for, they are presented, they are shaped first. This data is shaped, clear? This data is shaped by the organization, okay? And then what they are doing? Then what they are doing? They are making a graph. They are plotting a graph. Okay? They are making a diagram. Right now? So they are representing this data. So they are making the shape, providing the shape to the data. They are making this data based on this data, they are creating the statistical graph. Okay, they are creating the statistical graph. They are plotting the data. Okay, they are making the diagram so that organizations can understand the data efficiently, right? So that organizations can understand this data efficiently. So how you can define this data science? A data science analyzes the data. Okay, the data science, you can also define the data science that data science or data analysis. You can also mention it as a data, as a data analysis. Okay, so you can say that this data analysis or data science is a process of analyzing large set of data point to get answer on the questions asked by the business organizations. Clear na? So the role of the data science is what? Analyzing. So that for that analysis, that Panda is there. Panda is providing that analysis tools, right? Panda is providing that analysis tools, and Panda is manipulating the data. So how this Panda is manipulating this data? So for that Panda have various tool like data frame object, series. Okay, they are the very important tool for the Pandas. So obviously this will not be clear to you what is this data frame and what is the series. Now in brief, just I'm going to tell you that what the data is extracted from the data warehouse, what the data is extracted from the data warehouse, and when it is given and the data is not directly displayed or given to the business organization, that is shaped, and that shape is provided by this data frame. So the data frames organizes the data in the form of rows and column, and it displays to the organizations. Right now, so in next video we will see more about the Pandas. Okay, thank you.